Hello YouTubers and welcome to this new tutorial. Topic of this tutorial will be the paint realistic looking gems. I'm painting miniatures quite a while now, but some questions seem to be constant. One of these ever repeating questions is how to paint realistic looking gems or crystals. To attempt a good looking product or outcome in the end of the painting process, it often helps to gather some information, such as reference pictures. After gaining some knowledge about the subject, the second step has to be done: converting the learned real thing into the painting universe. Let us do this process together. Maybe this will also help you tackling different problems in the future. Basically, painting a gemstone or any glass-like or crystal structure on a miniature is to recreate the light effects and reflections on the gemstone. As one is not truly able to paint the transparency of glass, you have to simulate the effect and imaginary light source has to take the transparent gemstone. A good point to start is to take a look at one of those little glass stones often used as counters or collectible card games like Vampires or Magic, so when you're counting your tokens or whatever. In case of painting a gemstone, we have to focus on three main elements. First, the spot of the strong light or the source of the incoming light at all. Second, the direction of the light, which is directed from top to bottom. Third, the direction of shadow, which is directed inverse to the light, so from bottom to top. If we are able to imitate these major topics, we can create an artistic illusion, which will make our gem look realistic and fitting. Now we are beginning with the painting process. To show the painting process, I've taken this old Wraith Lord hat and started to painting on the first layer of color by using a mix of Chaos Black and MacLeod Red in a mix of 1 to 2 parts. I just hit the underside of the gems, nearly up to 50 or 60% of the whole gem. After that, I switched to MacLeod Red and just hit about 80% of the colored base of the gem. After that was dry, I just even took a more light color, just as bloody red or crimson red, and hit again about 60 to 70% of the former painted layer. At the end, I put out a yellow and marked the underside of the gems, so that when the light is coming out on the bottom, you have this working effect of breaking light inside of the gem. Last step is hitting the bottom with a white dot and the top with a kidney formed spotch. I used gloss varnish to give it a bit of extra glossiness so that the gem will look really like a stone or a gemstone. And here you are, the finished product. our gem, glossy and fine. I will also show some other examples of how this technique can be used. Here are some red stones. Blue and green is also available, so all the other colors. And also visors of armor or pinpoints can be done with this technique. Thank you for watching. Please vote, comment and subscribe to my channel if this video was helpful for you and help my channel grow. Thanks, goodbye, your war painter.